them, we meet with them tomorrow night. The black people need to stop worshiping the white man and start serving God. God, you repeat that after me, please. I said, God, that's not heavy. But I put on faith what I'm told to do. Would you repeat that with me? Black people. Need to stop. Worshiping the white man.
Stop serving God.
I'm going now into the Bible because I use it as a textbook for black liberation. It was my book for the attempt. Now y'all take that. I'm going, and some of you brought your Bible with you. Feel free to open it with me if you want to. I'll tell you, I'm going to take your time now.
Same time.
Matthew, the 6th chapter, the 24th verse. And we read, no man can serve two masters. Serve two what? For either he will hate one and love the other, or else he will hold to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and man. Now let us do a little exegesis, as they say in the seminary, on this text. Let's do a black nationalist commentary. Everybody else has commentary. Papa has commentary. Baptists have one. I'm not coming out on nobody. Methodists have one. Catholics have one. Everybody got a commentary. This is a black nationalist commentary. If they can do it, we can do it. After all, it is our book. Says here that no man can serve two masters, and that's true. What this text is demonstrating is an illness that we suffer, all of us suffer from. And in order for us to be made whole and to be healed of mind, body, and spirit, we have to stand up and admit that we suffer from this illness. The same way as they do in Alcoholics Anonymous, the first thing they have to stand up and do is say, I'm an alcoholic. Right. Accept that fact. Yeah. First of all, we have to accept the fact that we are sick. The enemy made us sick. Now, accepting that fact is the first step towards healing. We shouldn't face it. We should be about business and getting well. But the Lord is not going to turn the world over to no more sick people. ADA sick people running for about 6,000 years, you can't have. He wants the whole people to rule. And then he's calling the original black man and black woman back. Well, when you are trying to serve two masters, there's a dichotomy going on within your spirit. And that dichotomy causes you to be schizophrenic. Therefore, you act in an irrational manner when you act. You're, as Dr. Ben says, we're all schizophrenic. You have to act this way around a white man, or this God. Then act this way when you're home around your brothers and sisters. Now, I'm not saying you should go out tomorrow like we did in the 60s and 70s, although most everything we did was necessary to get to this stage. And tell white folks about everything you're doing and shake your fist in his face and say, we're going to get you, white. You know, don't do that. Don't do that. Wait a minute. Don't do that. You go out there and you work and you do and you carry on just about the same. Make sure you keep your dignity and respect. But this time, you're not schizoid about it. This time, you're not insecure around it, wondering how you should act. And when one of them speaks to you, you become so overjoyed, you almost stumble over yourself. But you will see them as they are. Yet you are wise enough to go on and conduct your business in a humane way, in a cordial manner, understanding that one day the decision might come between you and them. Or your child and their child. And you must have the wisdom to make the right decision. Which is naturally, you're going to go for your child and for self. Now we know that that potential is always there. But you don't have to carry that burden with you every day. Now we know when you come back into your community, you kind of shed that off and you feel relaxed. See, hey, man, what's that? Hey, baby, it's so good to see you. Sister, see, tell the child, they really got butter from the dump on that job. Dang, I'm so glad to be home. So it keeps us into that schizoid way. We We go within us and sense that there's something special about us as a race. We know we're not supposed to be in this position or condition in the world. We sense that we are supposed to be the powers in the world. Yet we have accepted someone else's rulership and have given in to it. There is within us a conflict as to why we go and prepare to get a degree to get a job rather than to get a degree to go in business and do something for self. That question is in your mind, so it causes schizophrenia instead. But when you come to the knowledge of self and begin to apply that knowledge in your daily life, you can go on as if nothing has changed to the rest of the world, but you and your brothers and sisters know what you're about and what you're in the midst of doing. But now, when it speaks of serving these two masters, you should have only one master.
That's right.
That's the Creator. I've never had a boss in my life. The only boss I've ever had outside of the Ishakamusabarashango has been the Almighty One, the Creator boss. That's the only boss I recognize. Whenever I've had to be in a position of employment with the enemy, and I thank the Creator, that's been very seldom, but there has been. I presented it to him this way. White folks don't like this either. I'm a businessman. I'm in business for myself. I'm marketing my skills to you. We're making a contract agreement here. For X amount of dollars, I'm going to do this for you. That's what that is. I'm not working for you. You are not my boss. And it bothers me to hear black folks talking about white folks being their boss. I got in the boss man watching you. Remember, I was talking one job as a printer one time. The brother came over and said, you know, man, you better be careful, man watching me. Said, which man you talking about? I'm a man, you a man, you talking about the man watching me. If you talking about the people that own this place, if he a man, I'm not going to stand that door and watch me. He has no business being in the business. I'm going to make profit standing in the door watching me. I'm doing my job. This is the point I'm trying to talk to. So the only master you should have is the Creator. Now, when you have another master, true, you're not on the plantation, so to speak, as overtly as it used to be. You know we still own one. Yet, though that child slavery is gone, the mental and spiritual and economic enslavement is still there. So every day we go to work, I'm not telling you to quit your job tomorrow, I'm not saying be no fool. If you're going to go into business, prepare yourself ready. But every time we go to work, we're serving another master. But that's something you got to feed your family, you have to live. But you should be preparing to get from under that master as soon as you can. That is nothing new. The Honorable Martha Starby, the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, and many others have presented this. But what we're really speaking about in serving the masters is who you give your mind, your body and soul, your spirit, your emotion over to. You know, your very being over to. And when you give your very being over to white folks, and we do that because they control our minds. And one of the ways they control our minds is through the imagery, which comes to us first through the basic step in our education, which is usually the church school. Now, brothers, don't get upset. I'm not coming down on the church. I love the church. I know what the church has done. I know in many instances it has been used against us. Yet we can transform the church and bring it back into the original glory that God intended for it. But it says here in the servant of these two masters, it says it's impossible to love the two. You may be serving the two, but you're going to love one and you're going to hate the other. Now I'm not teaching hate. This is impossible. It says that's nature. Human nature, you're going to love one force and hate the other force. I'm going to love the Creator. I'm going to love God. I'm going to love myself. I'm going to love my brothers and sisters. So that is what I'm going to serve in spirit, mind, and body. I might have to give him some lip service. I might have to give him a little work in exchange for the right amount of money. See, that's the contractual agreement there. But the master that I'm going to serve is myself and my Creator. That's what we're speaking of here. Now, when it goes on to say you cannot serve God and mammon, it's talking about the rulers of this present world. Now, I know that they control just about everything. You don't even control. You don't even know where to shut the water off. It's about a brother Bobby, right? That fallen warrior that passed on once. You don't even know where to to shut the water off at? Or cut it off, I didn't think shut it off. You been in your house with your basketball, you brought it inside and cut it all off, you out. Okay. You out. You understand what I'm saying? So they control the material world. But because they control it, then that means that you have to subject yourself to it. Even in the Christian doctrine, it says the devil are the rulers of this world, but you do not submit to this world. You submit to the will of God, the will of the Creator. And we will discuss that as we move on here. Let me move to the next text. There's a lot of Bible texts, though. Hope I can share it with you. For those who are having this schizophrenic trauma going on within their spirit, after which way to turn? Scared to be black. Afraid to be an out. Well, afraid to serve their own. Well, then, is that hatred in reverse?
Come on, wait.
I want to go to another Bible text for you. In the book of Joshua, the 24th chapter and the 15th verse. And I'm going to read that. I'm going to be opening for question and answers as soon as I can. And if it seem evil unto you to serve the Lord, it's a strange text, isn't it? But we're going to it. Choose ye this day whom you will serve. Do what?
Choose ye
this day. Don't be afraid to talk back together. Whom ye shall serve, whether the gods which your fathers served that were on the other side of the flood, or the gods of the Amorite, in whose land ye dwell. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Now, brothers dressed in white, they're in sorrow, brothers, explaining their literature all the time who the Amorite is. See, the wisdom and the knowledge is everywhere. You can get it from here, you can get it from there. We know who this Amorite is, representing the Caucasian. So now, which one are you going to serve? Make a choice, because you can't stand in the middle of the road. And why was Joshua putting this kind of challenge to the black nation Israel? That was a black nation, man. If you want to question me on that, when we finish, I'll be glad to deal with that. They were now getting ready to go into the promised land. They were not going to heaven. They were going into the land to establish a nation.
That's right.
The whole Bible is a book about securing some land. When the Republic of New Africa says, free the land, they're trying to follow the Bible. Because the Bible talks about freeing the land. When Abraham got up, he was going looking for some what? Some land. When the children of Israel left Egypt, they were going into Palestine, they were looking for some what? Always they were looking for some land. So that's what we're looking for, some land. Because you can't serve God correctly unless you're on your own land. No matter how hard you try, you're under the influence of the demonic forces around. And you can't accept the right systems of law and morality unless you're on your own land. We must have some land.